First, I got to ask you about this camp today.
Okay.
With you being such an influential person in women's sports, women's basketball, and seeing the talent that came out here today, what can you say about what you saw?
Just one thing, the big thing for me just wasn't a whole lot. We didn't have to really coach effort today, so that was a big thing. I can't really say there was one person who was lagging or, you know, one person we had to tell, hey, pick it up a little bit more. So that was a big positive thing. Also, too, just how a lot of the girls were ready to listen. A lot of them wouldn't listen. If you stopped and put them to the side, corrected them, there wasn't no kickback. It was just, hey, yes, yes, ma'am, or whatever, just to get better. So that was great.
What do you think young ladies get out of camps like this?
I think just knowledge. People who they bring in, us, all the former athletes, former college athletes, national champions, WNBA players. I think knowledge is a big thing, and just a lot of skill work they've probably never seen before. Just a lot of people who's just willing to just invest more into them, and just people who care about the game of basketball too. So that was major.
Now, I was talking to Michaela and Kyvin, and they were talking about they never went to camps that were outside of their school, or all of the camps they went to were outside of the state.
Right.
And what was your experience coming up?
I was years before them. I think I had probably only went to one camp, and it was like an exposure camp when I was in eighth grade. So that was a big thing too. Like this type of showcase where you're going to get the skill, you're going to get the play all around, all that things. You get to learn a little bit more. So that was major. This is the first thing I've seen anything like this in Kentucky, period.
How much do you think women's and girls' basketball are changing in the state?
A lot. I think the big thing, I think, is a lot of people, is AAU isn't a big thing for the most part. A lot of people are doing things on their own or getting personal trainers. I think trainers is a big thing, too, as well, that I'm hearing. But I think it's still important that you still come in groups to see, you know, showcase yourself against other people and see where you're at.
So when you train, what do you think is the biggest thing that the girls have already got under their belt? Have, you know, that you're surprised that their skill level may be at? Or what are some of the things that you see consistently that they're missing?
The basics, little things. As far as, you know, if you're on the right-hand side of the floor making a right-hand pass, or if you're on the left side of the floor making a left-hand pass, little things. Or just talking, just communication, just understanding the call-out screens, understanding just to say pick and roll. Just little things like that is what I really look for that I see that they're really lacking.
Now, you were able to translate your game to the next level and be successful.
Yes.
Now, when you were their age, what were some of the things that you were doing to be just a little bit better and to be consistent, consistently good at?
One thing that I do, I watched a lot of basketball. I went to stuff like, if I knew, if I was their age, if I was younger, if I knew something like this was going on, even if I wasn't open up, I was asking to go watch. Just so I could see the players, what they're doing. There was a whole lot of people, players that I could tell you that I watched growing up, that, you know, I wanted to be just like. So me just watching the game and me just working on my own outside game, I was the kid who was asking somebody, hey, let's go to the gym, let's work out. You know, I was the one who took initiative to make my game better. So really just big thing, just kids just watching the game to understand the game, because I think that's key.
Now, I talked a little bit about your success at Tennessee Tech.
Mm-hmm.
Talk a little bit about that. Tell us, I could run down a list of things that you were able to do, but talk a little bit about how well you played.
I had a great career at Tennessee Tech. The freshman year, I was like any typical freshman. I came in thinking I was going to come be the person, be the man. Didn't work that way. I came in thinking I was going to be strictly off talent and be better than everybody else. But, I mean, to be honest, I probably was, but that work ethic wasn't there. You know, I wasn't making my mile times. I had to do, that was the big thing I talk about my freshman year in college. You know, we had to do a first day of school mile. It took me 4 times to run it. That's all it took for me to just turn my whole career around. Just those running that mile 4 times, I told myself, I'm never going to do that again. So it don't matter if I didn't work out like I should have the summer before, I had the mental toughness to make that mile time every single year. So really just my career, I did great, played in 2 conference championships, top 10 in all categories, points, steals, assists, you name it. But I put the work in, I worked hard. I was the scorer in college, so everybody was working on how to stop me. So every single year, I changed something up about my game. So I wasn't doing the same thing last year that I was doing. I wasn't doing the same thing this year that I wasn't doing last year. So I just took the time just to change my game every single year to get better.
Now, you were able to go from the middle of nowhere, you know, small town USA,
mm-hmm.
to competing on a Division I level across the country. What kind of advice can you give to some of these young ladies who are in the same situation? Yeah. That they feel that, hey, I'm in the middle of nowhere. Nobody's gonna pay attention to me. I shouldn't have to work on my game as hard.
I think for me, the biggest thing that I had was heart. You got heart. Heart's gonna take you a long way. Heart's gonna outshine any kind of talent that anybody has. Heart's gonna outshine height. Heart's gonna outshine anything. If you go out there in the court and you put 110%, make sure people know who you are, whether you're doing little things, whether you're diving on the floor for balls. Not necessarily scoring. Everybody thinks you have to score a bunch of points to get noticed. Do those little things. That's what I did. I played with people who went to the Final Four on my AAU team, people who played in the WA, but who still playing to this day. But I made sure I did all the little things for people to know, hey, that's the car. People are gonna find out where I was, you know, or where I came from, just because I did all those little things. So just always just work hard, and just your heart outweighs talent anytime.
My last question is about being a leader on the court, on and off the court. What kind of advice can you give to some of these young ladies about that?
Just talk. Don't be afraid to step up. Somebody's got to do it. Might as well be you. Just making sure that, you know, when you're giving that 110%, always just make sure you're holding yourself accountable first. Because when you're giving that 110%, everybody else has no choice but to listen to you, and nobody else has no choice but to go hard because they see that's what you're doing. So just making sure you're the one who's the self-starter, making sure you're going 110% always, so that way you can lead by example.